This week's bait demo is using two sea lice for Pompano and Stumpies. It's staying with that whole concept of natural baits again. So there they are, two sea lice. What we require for that, again, 16 kilo Kingfisher, soft and supple line, latex cotton, 5-0 suis, combination again, fours and fives, fives and sixes, and a little chocker hammer that I might use or might not use, but we'll just go through it now. Okay, first things, join the nylon to the hook. It does not have to be a long trace, or should I say a very long trace. Where we're targeting these fish is more in the rougher white churning water for the Pompano and the Stumpies, but you could still get grunter there, for instance. So we're going to keep it a lot shorter. We don't want it to tangle up. Okay, again, just utilize it by doing a figure of eight. 1, 2, 3. Okay, what we've got here is a little piece of hair curler. Okay, instead of a wishbone, I'm using a hair curler with a little bit of low density foam. All I'm going to do is tie it up with our latex cotton. And the reason we use that is to give it something to hold on to, give the sea lice something to hold on to. Just quickly do this. Okay. There's my 5-0 sui. I'm now going to take that and just stick it over the top and tie that on. So basically that's what it looks like. The foam is on the inside just to give it neutral buoyancy in the water. Those little spikes from the hair curler actually penetrate into the sea lice and actually holds it on a lot better for casting purposes. What I'm going to do is just finish it off quickly by putting the hole. Okay, just grab another piece of nylon for the sinker snooting. Okay, just measure the length, and that's more than fine. Take our sinker. You can clip it if you want, you don't have to. If you need to get onto that far bank, trace is not right length, so I'm just going to cut and redo it. It's way better. And that's basically the length sinker, same length as the actual bait. You can change it if you want. If you want to have the sinker a little bit longer, I prefer it to be the same. It doesn't twist as easily in the air when you're actually casting this bait. Okay, let's grab our sea lice. Okay, easiest way, you can either use your chocker hammer and hit it to get some of that smell out, especially on the top there, or you can take them and just peel off the actual shell. Just to expose a lot more of that flesh. Do that again on the second one. Okay. There we go. You can see all that lovely juices now starting to come out of that sea lice already. Okay. This part of it goes on, and the feet showing outwards. Grab our latex cotton, and all we do is we lightly bind that on, preferably going between each of the legs so that there's a lot more movement in the water with the legs and making it look more natural. This one, just slide it underneath and just spread those legs out a bit. Look at that. Again, we're going in between the legs to try and get those legs as exposed as possible. And just work our way down. There we go. We've got the legs showing. We've got the hook very much exposed. So any pompano or stumpy that come along that actually bite on it, there's also a lot of smell and flavor going into the water. And that's basically what we're trying to achieve. And there's the made up trace. Guys, if you're gonna use exotic baits like sea lice or prawns or crabs, you need a permit. Make sure you get it from your local post office.